At the end of the 1990s, people infected with HIV in the developing world were finally able to join in the race alongside all those already living with HIV. Compared to 15 years ago, first-line AIDS treatment costs 100 times less, and the number of people with access to it has increased 50-fold. Scientific advances and developments in medical care have resulted in a drop in AIDS-related deaths and new cases of HIV infection. 15 years ago, only those already suffering with AIDS and severely weakened by the virus were offered treatment. But since September last year, the WHO recommends that anyone infected with HIV should begin treatment as soon as possible after diagnosis, as this increases their chance of survival while reducing the risk of the virus being transmitted to partners. There are even predictions that the end of the AIDS epidemic may be in sight. Sadly, it's not that simple. Of the 35 million people infected with HIV and who should therefore have access to treatment, there are still 20 million who don't. And starting treatment is only the beginning. Take the example of someone living near Lake Victoria in Kenya's Ndiwa district. HIV prevalence here is among the world's highest, with one quarter of the population HIV positive, and two adults in every 100 becoming infected annually. This inhabitant of Ndiwa has been able to get a diagnosis and has been offered treatment, but he must remain vigilant and he needs the support of the system. Thanks to effective treatment, the viral load in his blood has become undetectable. It's so low that tests can't measure it. But if he doesn't receive support with persevering with his treatment, if his and his medical team's vigilance lets up, the consequences will be disastrous. Not only will the virus start replicating again, it will also become resistant to the drugs used to treat it. Without appropriate medical supervision, such as routine measuring of the level of HIV in his blood, the medical team won't have the information they need to adapt their treatment strategy. And even if they do, there's yet another hurdle, as second and third line treatments are more costly, or often quite simply unavailable. Our patient, who had an undetectable viral load and was in good health, falls sick again. And once more, he's at risk not only of transmitting the infection, but also of dying. MSF has thus decided to take action in Ndiwa on all aspects of the disease, from diagnosis through to treatment follow-up, so as to ensure nobody falls out of the race. Simplifying treatments, offering routine, individualized support, adapting care strategies to suit each person, this is what is required to allow people living with HIV to persevere in the race against the disease.